We are constantly bombarded with, oh my God, everybody in Venezuela is dying because socialism is inefficient and people are running out of food because socialism inherently causes food to disappear. Well, one guy by the name of Austin Otazorina, I hope I'm saying that right, he's a Basque executive that's living in Caracas, and he kept getting hit with all these accusations by his family. They would say, oh, hey, there's no food there, are you starving, etc. So what he did was, on May 20th, he took a bunch of pictures of the grocery store near him. And now, what he ended up noticing when he did it was that all the grocery stores that have shortages in the poor areas had a shortage of food, but the ones in the rich neighborhoods just seem to be fully stocked and have a whole ton of luxury items, which is certainly indicative of what's really going on here. I mean, if the poor neighborhoods don't have food, but the rich neighborhoods are overstocked, I mean, if there is a general shortage, wouldn't they be relatively the same? Because I think what's really happening here is the fact that the poor are being marginalized, they're being scared, they're being terrorized by intentional shortages created by the bourgeoisie and imperialist efforts. Meanwhile, the rich people that are on the side of the U.S. and are anti-Bolivarian revolution are the ones who are making out just fine. Now, here's one of the captions that he put to the photos that was very telling. If you have money, there is champagne, vodka, Belgian chocolates, lobsters, brand name clothes, exclusive restaurants, nightclubs, beaches, yachts, golf clubs, a whole country within a country where there are no poor. Women and children are blonde, go to exclusive schools, exclusive universities, and vacation, where blacks and poor are the waiters. So what we're really seeing is what's left of the class divide within the country, which has not yet been dealt with by the Bolivarian Revolution, which is no doubt being backed up by imperialist intervention, by sabotage that's being carried out by the capitalist class in the country. Now, there are facts like this that are being deliberately obscured by the mainstream media in order to forward the interests of U.S. imperialism. I mean, should we really be surprised that there is like a whole separate world for people who are rich and a separate one for people who are poor? And guess who is aligned with who? The poor are aligned with the revolution and the rich are aligned with imperialism. And I think that's something that needs to be put out more, that should be gotten to the public much more when they're considering what's going on in Venezuela. It's far from this idea that somehow socialism is just inherently destroying everything, because the rich seem to be getting off just fine with a significant amount of luxury items and luxury places to go, while the poor are being decimated. I sincerely doubt that socialism is benefiting the rich and destroying the poor, because that kind of sounds like, you know, the opposite of socialism. So I think this is information that should be put out and should be made more available to the public so that people can get a real view of what Venezuela is going through right now. Thank you for watching. Want to go ahead, rate, comment, subscribe, and share on various social media. And if you want, you can head over to my Patreon page and show your support. Or you can head over to the MRN bookstore and check out some of the latest books available.